my god.
Dude, I totally forgot that happened. When you get to the bottom, you like crotch bang the pole. Oh, that hurts so good.
What?
Oh, that hurts so bad.
Yeah. What's up?
Hey guys, what's up? It's Liza. Today, I'm at the playground trying not to look creepy as I run around with a camera filming and talking to myself at age 19 on a playset. Wow, creepy. Anybody want some candy? But today I'm gonna be talking about some recess slash playground slash elementary school memories that we all have from back in the day. In elementary school, there was always that ridiculously good-looking young boy that everybody had a crush on. And of course he had some kind of hot guy name like Chad. But do you guys ever look at a kid and think, dang, you're gonna be really fine when you grow up? I've mentioned this to some people, like, hey, isn't that kid gonna be a cutie when he grows up? And they're always like,
wow, way to be a pedophile.
No, I'm not. My bad, dude, I can just predict attractive people. But I mean, there's just those kids that you're like, when you're done cooking, you're gonna be good looking. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, there was always that one kid who was insanely attractive for a 6-year-old. Turns out he peaked in elementary school and now he's a creep. And of course, there was always that gorgeous girl in elementary school. Her name was like Vanessa.
Screw you, Vanessa.
And all the boys had a crush on her because she was growing a little faster than the others.
Know what I'm saying?
I actually had a friend who was that girl, and she was all boom, 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 boom at like age 10, and I looked like a freaking cereal box standing next to her. Now, if you're wondering what I looked like as a child, you should stop.
It ain't cute.
Back in the day, I rocked some Skechers. I wore baggy unisex pants. Unisex meaning it ain't unisex, meaning it's only meant for boys, meaning girls should not wear them. Thanks, Mom. And I'd pair those baggy pants with, of course, some giant t-shirts. My hair was slicked back into a tight ponytail that looked like it was straight up protruding from the back of my neck. I looked like I was playing in a Mexican band. Then, after my hair was in a ponytail, I would pull a strand out, just like this, and I called it my bangs.
What is that? This ain't bangs, this is a bang.
Not even like a good bang, like a bang.
It's a bang!
Anyways, enough about me being a little man boy for most of my life. Let's get to the playground.
I'm so excited, I haven't been on a slide like this in years.
That was way more fun as a child.
These things at the park were the most legit things.
Why is it so zoomed in? Oh my god.
This was like a kid's first cell phone. Like somebody would stand at the other one and you'd whisper some dirty secrets about Billy.
Screw this stuff. This stuff freaking hurts.
Still, it hurt as a kid and it hurts now.
Who was the person that decided, yeah, let's put a bunch of this stuff all over the playground. It won't hurt when kids fall on top of a bunch of freaking splinters.
Oh yeah.
I wonder how much poop is in there.
I used to always fly off of swings, and I used to be such a boss at it. You ain't ready, fool. Suck on that!
You know what? I probably shouldn't scream suck on that in a children's playground.
Sorry.
So at recess, the boys and the girls would always separate. Cause cooties, bruh, cooties. So the stereotypical thing would happen where boys would run off and play soccer or football or play in a pile of poop, while the girls would go pick flowers and make flower crowns. Meanwhile, I was busy trying to master the baby bike. What is that, you may ask? When I was a kid, I swear this pole looked like the longest drop down. So I never did it. Not anymore though, cause I'm grown now. Dude, if you could do the monkey bars, you were a boss. A playground boss.
You can't do it, Sally.
Bro, shut up, Carl. Yes, I can.
Then prove it.
Man, Carl, eat my crayons, bro. Watch me do this. Woo! I legit could not do the monkey bars until like fifth grade. By fifth grade, you're starting to lose your baby fat.
No, it's still there.
And then you're finally able to do the monkey bars
like a boss.
White calluses that would show up on your hands after doing the monkey bars, and then they would peel, but you felt like a boss.
If you were hanging out in the tunnel all recess, you were either picking your nose, farting in private because you were gassy from the meatloaf you got from the cafeteria for lunch, or you were swapping cooties with Billy.
Kiss me, Billy.
And when teachers were around at recess, you were well behaved. But as soon as they looked away,
oh, hi, Miss Pattinson.
So I legit have to leave the park now because a family came in and I can see the parents hiding their kids from me. Or maybe they just want to play hide and go seek. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and please subscribe. Also, please comment below some of your playground recess memories.
Don't go!
All my other social media links are below.
I'll see you guys next Wednesday with Liza. Bye. There is so much freaking pressure to take the perfect selfie. So hopefully today's tips will help you take yours and teach you how to take the most bomb one ever.